the pack.png image. Whenever I see it, I feel nostalgia. It's that little taste of old school Minecraft that still exists in the game today. But every time I saw it, I kept wondering, is this image a real place in Minecraft? Could it naturally generate in the game? What if I wanted to build a base on that exact mountain? Well, back in January, I uploaded a video about this iconic Minecraft image to hopefully figure out the exact origin of it. The end goal was to get a world seed so that anyone can generate this exact map that this image was taken in. Let's just say the response was incredible. I received thousands of comments from people wanting to help, and the Salsi One Discord server went from around 2,000 to 10,000 members seemingly overnight. This is where the discussion of where to start looking for this image began. First, it started out with me tweeting at the original developers of Minecraft to see if they know anything about the image. And believe it or not, Notch himself responded to my tweet saying that he didn't remember where it came from or even where he took it. He also hinted at it being a completely random seed. And crazy enough, Notch actually joined my Discord server and discussed the project with us. What a mad lad. Then, out of nowhere, Dinnerbone responded to Notch's tweet, which is incredible on its own, as this was the first time Dinnerbone publicly spoke to Notch in years, saying that it might have been the flyby seed. But the main issue is that when the image was taken, the input of seeds didn't even exist yet, but world seeds themselves did. Regardless, the community searched the flyby seed anyways, but like I did with the Mojang seed, they found nothing. If you couldn't type in seeds at the time of the image's creation, then it must have had to be random. So at this point, specific seeds were ruled out entirely, and the main focus of the project was put towards reverse engineering the seed. This was led by many of the people that helped find the seed of PewDiePie's Minecraft world, so this was certainly their territory. But there's something to keep in mind. The only officially released size of this image was 128 by 128 pixels. That's a whole lot less than the hours of 1080p footage that they had of PewDiePie's world. So the lack of information in the image compared to other seed finding projects would certainly pose a challenge. But regardless of that, the team had high confidence that they would eventually find it. So that's when everyone started looking for every possible clue they could pull out of this image. First, the clouds. In Minecraft, clouds are based off of a repeating texture that moves along a static axis. By looking at the clouds in relation to the blocks, it is possible to find the approximate location in a Minecraft world on one axis. Combined with looking at the water texture to give the orientation, it significantly reduced the area that was needed to be searched in a potential world. This was noticed early on in the project, and at the same time, a new effort was starting to take place: physically recreating the image block for block. Now, this recreation project served two purposes. The first being simply a recreation, and second, it was pretty useful to the developers that were working on reverse engineering the seed. So exact block placements were needed to get accurate results, so the builders had to be careful. Arguments even started breaking out over which blocks went where, and I don't blame them. This is a very low resolution image, and it was very difficult to figure out where each block went. That now brings me to the image upscale project. Because certain blocks were just too difficult to see, an upscale was certainly needed. Using an off-the-shelf upscaler like Waifu2x did work, but it made the image look a bit splotchy. So that's where AI training came in. If the upscaler was trained with actual images of Minecraft, the resulting upscale should be a lot clearer. So Earth Computer, the head of the seed reverse engineering team, quickly created a mod that took screenshots of random Minecraft terrain. The mod was distributed to everyone who wanted to help, and we ended up with 1.7 million screenshots to train the AI with. And the result? Well, this. Although nobody, not even AI, can create data that didn't exist in the first place, it's still a lot clearer than the last one, and ended up helping fix a few areas that the builders were unsure of, as well as acting as a second opinion on where certain blocks should be placed. As the finishing touches to the recreation project were made, the programmers went to work. So to better understand how the seed reverse engineering is being done, I'm going to have to explain how Minecraft world generation works. So there are two stages of generating a world. First, the terrain, which consists of height, shape, caves, and basic blocks like stone, dirt, and grass. The second stage is population, where things like trees, flowers, and ores are generated. Both of these stages of Minecraft world generation mostly happen independently of each other. So if we only take the population seed, also known as the chunk seed, and separate that from the world generation seed, the amount of potential chunk seeds can be narrowed down a lot faster, especially since chunk seeds are not dependent on world position. So instead of trying to crack the potential world seeds, which would take ages, the potential chunk seeds could be cracked instead, and from there, the team can essentially work backwards to find a world seed. So what information can we use from this image to crack the chunk seed? Well, there's a lot of candidates here. The red areas represent things that can help us, and the blue is vice versa. So if we look closely at F, there's some flowers that were added during the population stage of world generation. However, the image does not show the entire patch of them or where the patch started generating from, which is needed for reversal. Now, how about that pig? Well, in older versions of the game, animals only spawn completely randomly and have no connection to the seed of the world, just like hostile mobs do. So this can't help us. Also keep in mind that blocks like grass and stone can't be used for our method of reversal, as they have generated in the terrain stage, not the population stage. So how about the waterfall? Well, this is actually perfect for chunk seed reversal, as they are quite rare to see spawning up this high. In fact, without this waterfall, reversing the chunk seed would have been near impossible. And the trees that surround the waterfall are also helpful, as they are likely to be within the range of the chunk seed border, which is 16 by 16 blocks. That's why the blue trees that are farther out can't be used to calculate the chunk seed. So once we have all of the potential chunk seeds calculated, that's when the next step of the project can get started, converting the potential chunk seeds to potential world seeds. And once the world seeds are narrowed down to just a few hundred, they can be searched manually, and bam! We'll have the seed to the pack.png image. So here's where we're at right now. The search is still on for potential chunk seeds, and this can take a while, as it is important to find where the chunk borders are in the image, which is crucial for seed reversal. Because a chunk is 16 blocks wide, that means that the team has to search 16 potential alignments. At this point, 11 of the 16 alignments have been searched. The last 5 have been proving more difficult, as there would just be too many potential chunk seeds that the team would have to go through. So a new methodology on how to deal with this is currently in the works. The bottom line is that this will take time. Finding a seed to an image that is only 128 by 128 pixels is a huge undertaking that can't just happen overnight. Plus, it has never even been done before. So in the meantime, a few side projects have been branched off from pack.png. One of which was to find the world seed to the X's Adventures in Minecraft Let's Play series. AntVenom makes a great video covering this project, so I'll leave a link in the description for that. Another side project that is currently in the works is a quest to find the tallest naturally generating cactus in Minecraft. This one's really interesting, so expect my own video on that soon. The great thing about these side projects is that the people involved start learning more and more about how Minecraft's intricate world generation system works, and the knowledge gained can certainly contribute to the pack.png project as a whole. Anyways, before I go, I want to give an enormous thanks to everyone that has contributed to the project so far. First, I want to thank everyone listed here that is a part of the seed cracking team. All of them, together, have made some kind of contribution that is getting us closer to finding the seed of this image once and for all. I also want to thank everyone that has contributed to the pack.png recreation project. Everyone you see in this room has helped with some part of the building project, so I want to give my biggest thanks to them as well. So like I said, we are not done yet. There's still a good ways to go on the project. If you want to get some more specifics that I couldn't fit into this video, I'll leave some resources in the description that should explain everything in more detail. The infamous pack.png image with a mountain, trees, and a waterfall is buried somewhere within the trillions of possible Minecraft world seeds. It exists, and it's not impossible to find. It just comes down to knowing where to look.